Okay, good afternoon all of you. Today we will continue the first chapter rational numbers and the second exercise of rational numbers exercise 1.2. Okay, so the first question is I have to represent the numbers 7 by 4 and minus 1 minus 5 by 6 on the number line. First of all, 7 by 4, if I have to represent 7 by 4 on the number line, I can convert it into the mixed fraction, that is 7 by 4 can be written as 1 3 by 4 in mixed fraction. Now I can represent 1 3 by 4 on the number line. What I can do is I can divide, this is 0, this is 1, and I can divide the region between 1 and 2 into 4 equal parts by making 3 lines or 3 points between 1 and 2. This is the first part. Okay, so I have divided the region between 1 and 2 in 4 equal parts by making 3 points or 3 lines. Now this part, the first part, it can be written as 1 by 4, or it is the 1/4 part of 1. Now the second point, I can write this point as 1 2 by 4 or 2 by 4th part of 1. And I can write this point as 1 3 by 4 or 3 by 4th part of 1, and the last point, that is 1 4 by 4, that is 2. So this is the point 1 3 by 4. Okay, coming to the next question. The next question is I have to represent minus 5 by 6 on the number line. Now minus 5 by 6, it will come in the negative part. So what I will do will, I will divide the region between 0 and minus 1, I will divide the region between 0 and minus 1 into 6 equal parts. 6 equal parts means 5 points. This is the first. Okay, so this are the 6 equal parts. I have divided the region between 0 and minus 1 into 6 equal parts. Now this first part will be minus 1 by 6. This will be minus 2 by 6. This part will be minus 3 by 6. This will be minus 4 by 6, and the last, this will be minus 5 by 6. So what I have to do is, minus 5 by 6, it will obviously lie between 0 and minus 1, so I will divide the region between 0 and minus 1 into 6 equal parts. 6 equal parts means I have to make 5 lines between 0 and minus 1. Okay, so the first line will denote minus 1 by 6, second will denote minus 2 by 6, third minus 3 by 6, fourth is minus 4 by 6, and the last minus 5 by 6, and this part is minus 6 by 6, that is minus 1. That means we have plotted the number correctly. Okay, now the second question, I have to represent minus 2 upon 11, minus 5 upon 11 and minus 9 upon 11 on the number line. Again, it is obvious that all these numbers will lie between 0 and minus 1. Now what I will do is, I will divide the region between 0 and minus 1 into 11 equal parts. 11 equal parts means I will draw 10 lines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and this is minus 1. So what I have done is, I have divided the region between 0 and minus 1 into 10 lines or 11 equal parts. This first line will be minus 1 by 11 because I have divided it into 11 parts. So the first part will be minus 1 by 11. The second part will be minus 2 upon 11. The third part will be minus 3 upon 11. The fourth part, minus 4 upon 11. This will be minus 5 upon 11. Minus 6 upon 11. Minus 7 upon 11, this will be minus 8 upon 11, minus 9 upon 11, and this part will be minus 10 upon 11, and lastly minus 11 upon 11, that is minus 1. So I have divided the region between 0 and minus 1 into 11 equal parts, that is by drawing 10 lines between 0 and minus 1. The first is minus 1 by 11, second minus 2 by 11, minus 3 by 11, minus 4 by 11, minus 5 by 11, then minus 6 by 11, minus 7 by 11, and up to minus 1. So the points which we need is minus 2 upon 11, minus 5/11 and -9/11. Okay, the next question. I have to write 5 rational numbers which are smaller than 2. Now, there can be many rational numbers which are smaller than 2. I have asked 5 rational numbers, then it can be 1, 0, -1, half, -2, and so on. So, okay, there can be many rational numbers. I can write there are many rational numbers which are less than 2. There are many rational numbers which are smaller than 2. For example, 1, 0, -1, 1/2, -2, and so on. There can be many other such examples. Okay, and the next question is, find 10 rational numbers between -2/5 and 1/2. Now, what I have to do is, I have to convert -2/5 and 1/2 into the same denominator. That is, I have to make both the fractions with the same denominator. If I convert -2/5, if I convert the denominator into 10 by multiplying it with 2, it will become -4/10. And 1/2, if I convert 1/2 with the denominator 10, I will multiply it with 5/5, that is 5/10. Now, if I see -4/10 and 5/10, there are only 8 rational numbers between -4/10 and 5/10. But I have to insert 10 rational numbers. So, I have to choose some different denominator. What I will do is, I will multiply -2/5 with 4/4. So, the denominator will become 20. -2/5 into 4/4, that is -8/20. Again, I will make the denominator of 1/2 into 20. So, I will multiply 1/2 with 10/10, that is 10/20. Now, I can write the rational numbers which are lying between -8/20 and 10/20. That is -7/20, -6/20, -5/20, -4/20, -3/20, -2/20, -1/20, 0, again positive rational numbers, 1/20, 2/20, 3/20, 4/20, and up to 10/20. So the rational numbers, or the 10 rational numbers between -2/5 and 1/2 are these. Why I have not chosen 10 as the denominator? Because if I want to insert -4/10 and 5/10, if I find the rational numbers between these two rational numbers, there are only 8 rational numbers between -4/10 and 5/10. Therefore, I choose the denominator as 20. I multiplied -2/5 with 4/4, that is -8/20, and 1/2 with 10, that is 10/20. Now, I can insert many rational numbers between -8/20 and 10/20. So, the 10 rational numbers between these two numbers are from -7/20 up to 10/20. Okay, thank you all of you.